Well, a new round in the fight over sectarian prayer before board meetings in Carroll County. Board members were sued for prayers that referred to Jesus Christ. But in a case out of New York State, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled today that such prayers do not violate the Constitution, which Carroll County board members say sets a precedent in their case. 11 News reporter Kai Reed has that story tonight from Westminster.
The Lord Jesus Christ. To admit me to
even after a district court judge told them not to, Carroll County board members continued to pray before board meetings.
Please bring your protection.
One board member even said that she'd be willing to go to jail for her right to do so.
I'm not sure how strongly they feel about it. I'm willing to go to jail over it.
This case started when a group of concerned citizens filed suit saying that board members' sectarian prayer before meetings violated the First Amendment. The majority of board members disagreed, and now they feel that a Supreme Court decision out of New York State proves them right. In the town of Greece versus Galloway case, the High Court ruled that the town's practice of prayer before legislative meetings did not violate the Constitution. Reached by phone, David Niosi, an attorney for the Carroll County plaintiff, says that the New York case and the Carroll County case are very different.
The decision today in the Greece case by the Supreme Court actually is a ruling that's limited to legislative prayer led by chaplains or clergy. Here in Carroll County, what we have is commissioners leading the prayers themselves and leading sectarian Christian prayers on top of that. It's just an apples and oranges analogy.
The district court judge in Maryland lifted the injunction against legislative prayer in Carroll County after the New York ruling came down Monday. And Carroll County board members issued a statement saying, in part, the board is very pleased with the Galloway decision, and the commissioners are deeply gratified that Judge Quarles lifted the injunction prohibiting sectarian prayers.
No, I do not think that they should be able to pray before, because there's too many religions out there, and if you're going to do it for one, you got to do it for everybody.
I don't think anybody should be able to tell you whether you can pray or not.
There is still a contempt motion in place filed when the legislative prayers continue despite the initial injunction back in March. Despite the Supreme Court ruling, plaintiffs' attorneys say that their next step will likely be to ask for another injunction if the prayer continues.
The next Carroll County Board of Commissioners meeting is an open session scheduled for 9:45 Tuesday morning. Reporting in Carroll County, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.